What I'm showing you here on the screen, it's a PCB, which is more like an idea. I mean, this PCB doesn't exist yet. It's an idea of a PCB, very simple, just one FPGA and a bunch of connectors to be a good vehicle to make retro computers. I'm gonna say retro computers. I know there are so many other boards out there, but this is good. This is tailored specifically to the tutorials and design that I'm doing. It's not like a business, because those kind of things, they don't bring a lot of money, but it was more for, because of the people which they watched my videos, they were all asking what platform do you use, and I use a Z board, which is a fairly expensive board. So I'm trying to make this to help beginners to get into designing with FPGA. So I'm hopefully this board is going to be, you know, 99 euros. That's my target. I'm not even sure if it's possible. It might be. It's not going to make me rich, because I'm not planning to sell many. I'm going to sell 50 boards. But most of my tutorials, they're just going to fit directly here, so you can reuse the code that I'm posting online. Now let me see if I can show better what's on the board. Right, so let me zoom just a little bit. Yeah, something like this. I'm trying to take it out of the way here. So why did I highlight it? Something like this. So as input devices, there are four USB low speed connectors. So you will be able to plug a keyboard, a USB keyboard, a cheap one, and game controllers, like very simple game controllers. I'll provide the VHDL and very low code for this. Now this is a USB to serial bridge here. I'm not even sure if it's going to stay. You need to feed this board with 5-volt external. Now, how you program this board, this is a JTAG connector. So you can use one of the existing JTAG cables. I'm investigating the idea to integrate all the programming, so you don't need a JTAG, you just use a USB cable. I'm still looking if I'm going to do this or not. Some switches here, some PMOD. Those PMOD connectors, they have like 8 digital signals and 3.3 volts. And ground. What else? This is it's an HDMI connector. Actually, let me zoom a little bit. Right, it's an HDMI connector, but it's actually DVI, so I'm not sending any HDMI. HDMI can have sound, DVI doesn't have sound, so it's actually DVI over HDMI. We will be a bit limited in terms of resolution because of the speed of the FPGA. This is a VGA with a very crude DAC, like 5 bits per color, like 15 bits in total. Am I talking rubbish? 4 bits per color, so 12 bits in total. So it's a kind of crude VGA DAC. The rest, they're just switches. Now, there is an oscillator, 100 meg oscillator, and I might put a footprint for a second oscillator. Switches, LEDs, those things which they help you to debug things. And of course there is a mode switch here. Now the board will have a flash, so you can actually program the flash and boot the whole board, so you don't need a computer if you want to demo, for example, your design. Or I think it has some extra space there other than the bitstream, so you can use it if you want. The board doesn't have any external memory, so it relies on the internal memory on the FPGA. The FPGA is going to be a Spartan 7, not a very small one. It's going to be like a decent size FPGA, and the board will be designed to accept two sizes of FPGAs. That's pretty much about the board. Not much. There is not much on this board. This board was kept simple to be cheap. Now it's going to be probably another incarnation of this board with more fancy stuff, but this is just an idea. Let me know in the comment if you think that you know, it's a good idea or a bad idea. I know there are many boards out there, so I know that. But this is more for me, a vehicle to create those projects. And if people are interested, probably we'll sell a few directly from our website. And that's it. I hope you give me some feedback. And that's it. Enjoy.